This is Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we will verify the solution of the differential equation of simple harmonic motion, explain the physical meaning of X and XM, introduce the formulas of the angular frequency omega 0, natural frequency F0, and natural period T0, explain the role of the phase and the initial phase angle, and finally determine the expressions of the maximum speed and the maximum acceleration.
In the last video, we obtained the second order differential equation that governs the simple harmonic motion of a horizontal elastic pendulum. The solution or the time equation of this differential equation is x is equal to a cosine omega 0 t plus phi, or x is equal to a sine omega 0 t plus phi, where a, omega 0, phi, and phi are constants. Now, we will take one of the time equations and verify that it is a solution of this differential equation. But first, let me remind you with the derivative of cosine u. Let y of t be equal to cosine u, then dy by dt, or y prime, is equal to minus u prime sine u. Also, let y of t be equal to sine u, then dy by dt is equal to y prime, which is equal to u prime cosine u. Now, let's verify the solution x equal a cosine omega 0 t plus phi. Now, omega 0 t plus phi is taken as u. So what is the derivative of u? The derivative of phi is 0 because it is constant, and the derivative of omega 0 t is only omega 0. So, take the first derivative of the expression, x prime is equal to minus omega 0 a sine omega 0 t plus phi. Now, we will use the second math relation to differentiate this expression with respect to time. So, this is going to be x double prime is equal to minus omega 0 squared a cosine omega 0 t plus phi. But if you examine the equation, you will find that a cosine omega 0 t plus phi is equal to x. So, replace a cosine omega 0 t plus phi by x. This is going to be x double prime is equal to minus omega 0 squared x. Now, this is our differential equation. So, we will replace x double prime by minus omega 0 squared x. This is going to be minus omega 0 squared x plus omega 0 squared x is equal to 0. Therefore, x equal a cosine omega 0 t plus phi is a solution for the above differential equation.
In the last slide, we verified that x equal a cosine omega 0 t plus phi is a solution of the differential equation. Now, what does each term in this equation represent? Let's start with x. X is the abscessa of g, or it represents the elongation or the compression of the spring at any instant. Also, x is equal to delta L, which is the variation in the length of the spring, L final minus L zero. To understand more, let's watch this animation, where we have a horizontal elastic pendulum. The natural length of the spring is 20 centimeters. To start the oscillation, let's displace the block by a certain distance, and then it is released from rest. Okay, this distance is equal to 10 centimeters, so it oscillates between 10 and minus 10 centimeters. At a certain instant, the abscessa of the block is 6 centimeters, but the final length of the spring is 26. If you subtract 26 from 20, or 26 minus 20, you will find that delta L is equal to 6 centimeters. Now, 6 centimeters represents the abscessa of the block and the elongation of the spring. At another instant, the abscessa of G is minus 5 centimeters. If you measure the length of the spring at this instant, you will find that the length of the spring now is equal to 15 centimeters. But delta L, which is equal to 15 minus 20, is equal to minus 5. So minus 5 represents x and also represents the variation in the length. So the compression in the spring and in this case or at this instant is equal to 5 centimeters. Now, A. what is or what does A represent? The absolute value of A is equal to xm. As you know, xm is the amplitude or one of the properties of the oscillatory motion. But cosine omega 0 t plus phi has no unit. We conclude that x and A or x and xm have the same unit. If A in centimeter, then x in centimeter. If A in meter, then x in meter. Note xm is always positive. Now, what does omega 0 represent? Omega 0 is called the natural angular frequency or the natural pulsation of oscillation, and it is given by the formula square root of k over m. In SI, omega 0 is expressed in radians per second, and it is always positive. To understand the meaning of omega 0, let's watch this short animation where a block completes one oscillation. So, each oscillation, it corresponds to one cycle, and each cycle corresponds to 2 pi radians. The question now, if the block completes n oscillations per second, so n oscillations per second corresponds to omega 0. So, each oscillation corresponds to 2 pi radians, therefore, n oscillations per second corresponds to omega 0. If we make the cross product, we can conclude that omega 0 is equal to 2 pi times the number of oscillations per second. Therefore, omega 0 is the rate of oscillations multiplied by 2 pi, or it is the number of oscillations per second multiplied by 2 pi.
Now, let's move to the natural frequency f0 of the oscillations of x. f0 is the rate of oscillations, and as we have seen in the previous slide, omega 0 is the rate of oscillations multiplied by 2 pi. So this is going to be omega 0 is equal to 2 pi f0. Rearrange, f0 is equal to omega 0 over 2 pi. In SI units, f0 is expressed in hertz. Now, let's move to the natural period T0 of oscillations, which is called in some references as the proper period. So, T0 is equal to 1 over F0. So, replace F0 by omega 0 over 2 pi. So, this is going to be 1 over omega 0 over 2 pi. Rearrange. T0 is equal to 2 pi over omega 0. But omega 0 is equal to the square root of k over m. So we will replace omega 0 by the square root of k over m. This is going to be T0 is equal to 2 pi times the square root of m over k. So in SI units, T0 is expressed in seconds, the mass in kilograms, and the spring constant in Newton per meter.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, what does the term omega 0 t plus phi represent? Omega 0 t plus phi is the phase at an instant t. Since we have a time t in the expression of the phase, so the phase varies with the time. Now, what is the importance of the phase? As you know, during oscillation, the abscissa of the block varies between two extreme positions, which are minus xm or minus the absolute value of A and plus xm or plus the absolute value of A. Now, the position of the block or the abscissa x of the block depends on the value of the cosine of the phase. So, cosine of the phase times A gives the value of x. Let's say, for example, at an instant t, cosine the phase equals 0.2. So, at this instant, x equals 0.2 times A. Another example, if at a certain instant, cosine the phase is equal to minus 0.3. So at this instant, x equal minus 0.3a. We know that cosine for any angle varies with the time. The value of this angle or the value of cosine of this angle varies between minus 1 and plus 1. That leads to x also varies between minus the absolute value of a or plus the absolute value of a, or x varies between minus xm or plus xm. It depends on the value of the cosine of the phase.
Now, let's move to the initial phase angle or phase constant phi. Phi is expressed in radians. The value of phi depends on the values of x0 and v0. We have made a video about the determination of phi in the simple harmonic motion. You can watch it on our YouTube channel. Now, in order to verify that phi depends on the values of x0 and v0, we draw the curves of these two sinusoidal functions. As you see, they have the same amplitude and they have the same angular frequency, but they have different values of phi. In the first function, phi is pi over 2 radians, and in the second function, phi is 0. Now, consider the curves. So they have the same amplitude, which is 2 centimeters, and they have the same period, which is 5 seconds, but they have different initial conditions. In the first curve, x0 is equal to 2 centimeters, and then v0 is equal to 0. While in the second curve, x0 is equal to 0, and v0 is positive. So this verifies that the value of phi depends on the initial conditions x0 and v0.
Now, expressions of the maximum speed and the maximum acceleration. During oscillation, the speed and the acceleration are not constant. In the next video, we will show that the speed has a zero value at the extreme positions and has a maximum value at the equilibrium position. But now, what is the expression of this maximum speed? Using this time equation, x is equal to xm cosine omega 0t plus phi. So the algebraic value of the velocity of the block is equal to x prime, which is equal to minus omega 0 xm sine omega 0 t plus phi. So v varies with the time t. But the maximum value of sine omega 0 t plus phi is equal to 1. Therefore, the maximum value of the speed is equal to the absolute value of minus omega 0 xm because the speed is positive. So the maximum value of the speed of the block is given by omega 0 xm. Similarly, the algebraic value of the acceleration of the block is equal to the first derivative of v. Then a is equal to minus omega 0 squared xm cosine omega 0 t plus phi. As you see, a varies with the time t. But the maximum value of cosine omega 0 t plus phi is equal to 1. So, the maximum acceleration or the amplitude of the acceleration is equal to the absolute value of minus omega 0 squared xm, since am or the maximum value of a is positive. Therefore, am is equal to omega 0 squared xm.
Finally, let's focus on these two remarks. First, the natural angular frequency, the natural frequency, and the natural period are called the characteristics of the oscillator since they depend only on the spring constant k and the mass m. Now, what does this mean? This means that the natural angular frequency, the natural frequency, and the natural period of a certain oscillator would not change even if we change the initial conditions x0 and v0. Now let's move to the second remark. The amplitude xm and the initial phase angle phi can be calculated using the initial conditions x0 and v0.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.